Hi, my name's Liz from HLP Controls, and this unit is the Medi Log II. Now, this unit has been produced, designed and developed, and is also manufactured by us, HLP Controls. This is a vaccine storage data logger, and it meets all the requirements of the health department. It's perfect for food storage as well, so you can use it for storing anything you need to data log as storage temperatures. Now, what you get in the box. Open the box like this. You get, obviously, the Medi Log II unit. Let's remove this piece of packaging. Remove this one. You have a bag here, which contains the USB cable for setting up and downloading your logger, and also this, which is the sensor cable and the sensor itself. This plugs into the side of the unit. You also have the manual for how to use the unit, a certificate of calibration, and also a hook and loop fastener piece that you can use to mount the unit when you're ready to. Pop that all over there for the second. Now that's what you get in the box. Now the main features of this unit are it's a one button control. You don't have lots and lots of confusing buttons where you have to learn what each one does. It's a one button control, nice and easy to use. The probe temperature and the min max temperatures are always displayed on the home screen. It has a replaceable 3.6 volt battery located just in the back here. You can easily replace that yourself. It should last about a year with this battery, but anytime you need to, you can replace the battery yourself. It comes ready to use. So when you turn the unit on, it comes already set with the Department of Health's 2 degrees and 8 degree alarm points. If you're using this for storing food, then you can easily change that yourself. Change it to 5 degrees as the high alarm and a low alarm of whatever suits the food that you're storing. Now the software is free. You can download the software from our website. There's also a QR code on the back of the box, so you can actually scan the QR code and go to the website and download that software. There's no cradle needed, so you can have the software on different computers. You could download it to whichever computer is most convenient at the time. Now, mounting the unit, it's got magnets in the back. So you can actually plop it onto the side of the fridge if you have something which is you can magnetically attach to. Otherwise, you use that hook and loop fastener that I showed you a minute ago. Peel off the backing, stick it to the unit, peel off the other piece, stick it to your fridge. Now, it comes with everything, so it's ready to go straight out of the box. You don't have to buy anything else to make this unit work. Now, you can use it straight out of the box, but we recommend that you download and install the software on your computer. And then you can name the unit. You can call it Fridge 28 out the back. That way, all of your data that you store, all of the graphs that you have, will have that name on them, and it will signify which fridge they were all for. Now, once you want to do anything with the unit, you plug it in using the USB cable, which is supplied. So you plug that into the side of the unit here, and you plug the other end, obviously, into your computer. The software will automatically find the unit. If it's already been in use, then the software will find the unit, it'll download the data and display it on your screen, and it will save that file for you so that you've got no problems about lost files, lost information. If it's a first use though, what it will do is it will sync the time and date from your computer to the unit, so all of your data has the correct time and date. Now with the bottle, this is the sensor cable that comes with it. As you can see, it's about 2 meters long or so. With the sensor, it's located just inside this bottle. So you can unscrew the cap. You can fill the little bottle with glycol if you wish to, or water, or don't use the bottle at all. It's entirely up to you. But that's the little sensor bottle that comes with it. Once you've got the sensor how you want it, if you wanted to fill it with glycol, then pop it into about the middle of your fridge, run the cable outside, and mount the Medi Log II unit on the side of the fridge or on the front, wherever suits you, wherever it's going to be most convenient for you to be able to see and to use. Now, once you've got the unit going, Once you've meant it, you've set it up with a name and you've mounted up where your sensor should be, plug the sensor into the side of the unit. Then you can turn the unit on by just pressing that control button. To activate the unit, to actually start it, then you would press that button. This one has already been started. You'll press and hold that button for about 5 seconds. A red LED will flash up here, and then an arrow symbol will start flashing here. It will show you what the inside temperature is of the fridge, wherever that sensor is sitting. And this arrow will flash until your 30-minute delay is finished. Now you have a 30-minute delay before logging starts, and that's to make sure that your sensor gets down to your fridge temperature. Then once the 30-minute delay is finished, the unit will start logging automatically. Once you've finished logging and you want to download your information, all you do is leave the sensor in place, no need disturbing where that is. You need to switch the unit off by pressing and holding the control button again. Press and hold it for about 5 seconds until it flashes and the logging will finish. Then you unplug the sensor, take the unit to your computer and plug in your USB cable and download it. The software will automatically find the unit and it will download that software and it will store that information for you. Then you can set the unit up again, take it back to your fridge, plug it back in, start it back up, and it will start it all over again. The only time that it won't automatically stop when you press this button is if it's had an alarm. Now, if there's been an alarm, there will either be an up arrow or a down arrow showing on your home screen, and that will indicate whether your high alarm or your low alarm has been exceeded. The unit will also be beeping about every 5 seconds. Now, the minimum and maximum temperatures that the unit has reached will be shown on the screen, so you'll be able to easily see which of your temperatures has been exceeded. The unit won't turn off, you won't be able to turn the unit off. All you'll be able to do is unplug it, take it to your computer, plug it in with your USB cable and download the information. Now, the reason that we've made it so that it doesn't turn off is so that no one can reset it and not fix the problem that made your alarm. So that's why that it stays in alarm until someone actually downloads the information, resets the logger, and then we would assume then that someone is going to fix whatever the problem was. So this is the Medi Log II from HLP Controls, and it's the vaccine storage data logger, and it meets all of the requirements of the health department. Medi Log II. Thank you.